स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर फ्रॉम आर गुलमोहर बुक मटिल्डा कैन डू मैजिक। इट इज़ एन एक्सट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम द बुक मटिल्डा रिटन बाय रोल्ड डाल। मटिल्डा वर्मवुड इज़ अ ब्राइट, इंटेलिजेंट एंड गिफ्टेड चाइल्ड, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली हर पेरेंट्स वुड रादर हैव or watch the television than read a book. Matilda is a very bright, intelligent and gifted child. It means she is very intelligent, but her parents didn't care. Her teacher, Miss Honey, recognizes her brilliance and tries to help Matilda learn more, but both her parents and the headmistress, Miss Trunchbull, refused to allow her to do so. Miss Honey was the teacher of Matilda and she wanted to help Matilda, but Matilda's parents and the headmistress means the principal of the school, Miss Trunchbull, refused to allow her to do so. One day when Miss Trunchbull visits the class and finds a newt in her glass of water, she accuses Matilda of playing a prank on her and threatens to expel her. One day, Miss Trunchbull visits Matilda's class and he found a newt. Newt is a lizard type of animal in her glass of water, and she blamed Matilda for that and threatened her to expel the school. Suddenly the glass falls over and the newt lands on Miss Trunchbull, who is now angrier than ever. When the newt lands on Miss Trunchbull, she became more angry. Everyone has seen that Matilda has not moved from her seat. Then how did the glass fell? Now everybody watched Matilda not move from her seat, but how that glass fell. We will read the chapter and find out how the glass fell on Miss Trunchbull. Matilda did not join the rush to get out of the classroom. After the bell, all the children were running out from the classroom, but Matilda did not join them. After the other children had all disappeared, she remained at her desk. When all the children went out, Matilda was only child who was sitting at her desk, quiet and thoughtful. She was thinking something. She knew she had to tell somebody. She wanted to tell something to somebody about what happened with the glass. Matilda wanted to tell somebody what happened to the glass. She couldn't possibly keep a gigantic secret like that bolted up inside her. Gigantic means large or big. She did not able to hide a large secret which was inside her. What she needed was just one person, one wise and sympathetic grown-up who could help her to understand the meaning of this extraordinary happening. And Tilda wanted to tell that secret some grown-up which was wise and sympathetic. Neither her mother nor her father would be any use. Matilda did not want to tell her mother or father, for they would not believe her, because they would never believe her nor realize what an astounding event had taken place in the classroom that afternoon, because they will never believe her that what surprising event take place in her class that afternoon. On that supper of the moment, Matilda decided that the one person she would like to confine in was Miss Honey. At that moment, Matilda thought that she can tell her teacher Miss Honey about that incident. Matilda and Miss Honey were now the only two left in the classroom. Now only two person were in the classroom. One was Matilda and other was Miss Honey, the teacher of Matilda. Miss Honey had seated herself at her table and was riffling through some papers. And at this time, Miss Honey was sitting at her table and she was turning some papers. She looked up and said, well, Matilda, aren't you going outside with the others? Now, Miss Honey said to Matilda why she was not going outside with other children. Matilda said, please, may I talk to you for a moment? Matilda requested Miss Honey to talk to her for a moment. Of course you may. What's troubling you? And Miss Honey allowed Matilda to talk. Something very peculiar happened to me, Miss Honey. Now Matilda told Miss Honey that something very strange happened to her. Miss Honey became instantly alert. Now Miss Honey became very alert. Ever since the two disastrous meetings she had had recently about Matilda, because two incidents were happen in the past with Matilda and Miss Honey. So she became very alert. The first with the headmistress and the second with Mr. and Mrs. Vonwood. Miss Honey had been thinking a great deal about this child and wondering how she could help her. Incident were happened with Miss Honey, one with headmistress and second one with Mr. and Mrs. Vonwood. Miss Honey was thinking about this child and want to help this child, and Miss Honey want to help her. And now here was Matilda sitting in the classroom looking particularly exhilarated and asking if she could have a private talk. And now Matilda was in the classroom and wanted permission to Miss Honey for a private talk. Miss Honey had never seen her looking so wide eyes and peculiar before, and Miss Honey never seen her like this before. Yes, Matilda, she said, tell me what has happened to you that is so peculiar. Now Miss Honey asked Matilda what strange happened with her. Miss Trunchbull isn't going to expel me, is she? Matilda asked. Matilda asked Miss Honey that Miss Trunchbull would expel her from the school because it wasn't me who put that creature in the water. Now Matilda told Miss Honey that it was not Matilda that kept the creature in the water. I promise you it wasn't. Now Matilda confirmed that it was not she. I know it wasn't, Miss Honey said. Miss Honey also agreed with Matilda that it was not she. Am I going to be expelled? Matilda again asked. Miss Trunchbull expelled her? I think not, Miss Honey said. The headmistress simply got a little overexcited, that's all. Miss Honey said to Matilda that Miss Trunchbull was little angry, but she will not expel her from the school. Good, Matilda said, but that isn't what I want to talk to you about. But Matilda informed Miss Honey that this was not that thing about what she want to talk to her. What do you want to talk to me about, Matilda? Now Miss Honey asked Matilda what she wanted to talk to her. I want to talk to you about the glass of water with the creature in it, Matilda said. You saw it spilled all over Miss Trunchbull, didn't you? Now Matilda said Miss Honey that she want to talk to that glass of water that fell on Mrs. Trunchbull. You see, I didn't it. Now Miss Honey said he watched that. Well, Miss Honey, I didn't touch it. I never went near it. Now Matilda said Miss Honey that she didn't touch the glass and she never went near the glass. I know you didn't, Miss Honey said. You heard me telling the headmistress that it couldn't possibly have been you. Now Miss Honey told Matilda that I informed mistress that it was not you. Ah, but it was me, Miss Honey, Matilda said. But Matilda confirmed that it was she. That is exactly what I want to talk to you about. This is exactly what I want to tell you. Here Matilda want to say that it was she who spilled that glass of water on Mrs. Trunchbull. Miss Honey paused and looked carefully at the child. I don't think I quite follow you, she said. Now Miss Honey said Matilda that he was unable to understand her. I got so angry of being accused of something that I hadn't done that I made it happen. Now Matilda told Miss Honey that she was very angry for that what she had not happened and Miss Trunchbull was blaming on her. So, in anger, she did that. You made what happened, Matilda? Now, Miss Honey again asked Matilda, what happened? You did that. I made the glass tip over. Matilda said, he tipped over the glass. I still don't understand what you mean, Miss Honey said gently. Now again, Miss Honey very politely asked Matilda. She was unable to understand what she mean. I did it with my eyes, Matilda said. I was staring at it and wishing it to tip and then my eyes went all hot and funny and some sort of power came out of them and the glass just toppled over. Now Matilda told Miss Honey that she did it with her eyes. Miss Honey continued to look steadily at Matilda through her steel-rimmed spectacles and Matilda looked back at her just as steadily. Now Miss Honey was surprised and she continuously watching Matilda from his spectacles and Matilda also watching her. I am still not following you, Miss Honey said. Do you mean you actually willed the glass to tip over? Miss Honey again asked Matilda. She was unable to understand. Actually, she fell the glass. Yes, Matilda said, with my eyes. Once again, Matilda said, yes, he fell the glass with her eyes. Miss Honey was silent for a moment. She did not think Matilda meant to lie. It was more likely that she was simply allowing. Miss Honey was not thinking that Matilda is telling lie. But Miss Honey thought it was only the imagination of Matilda. Sometimes children imagine something. Children, I hope you will understand the first part of this chapter. Rest of the chapter we will complete in our next video.